So I have just recently been informed that we have some trainers teaching in a firearms instructor training program who are relating to their students that it is not necessary to be a good shooter in order to be a good firearms instructor. One of my favorite people on the internet is a little small blonde-haired boy sitting in the back seat eating on a Pop-Tart, and he responds to something someone said with bullshit, bullshit, and he's exactly right here. You must be a good shooter, at least above average, and have an advanced level of shooting skill in order to be an effective firearms instructor. This person even went further and said there was no direct correlation between being a good shooter and being a good firearms instructor. Absolutely untrue, categorically untrue. Now let's get into it. First of all, you have to diagnose and correct your own issues and mistakes before you're able to diagnose and correct someone else's mistakes. Every good instructor out there teaches from an abundance of knowledge. The more knowledge you have about your own shooting skills, the more effective you are at relaying that information to students in the future. Now, this person said, you're a grandmaster, you're a sponsored USPSA shooter. Do you think everyone has to be to that level? And the answer is no. Everybody doesn't have to be to that level. But you have got to be at least above average and then continue to work on your skills in order to be an effective firearms instructor. Now, these same people have tried to conflate with me in the past. Well, Roy Williams might not be able to make a three-point shot, but he's a good coach in the NCAA. A couple of issues here. If you're coaching someone, they have an above average level of skill already, and coaching and teaching are not the same thing. We're talking about life-saving skills here versus a game with a ball. You need to be shooting demonstrations if you're teaching your people as a firearms instructor. If you're teaching as a firearms instructor trainer, you've got to shoot demos. If your people are not doing demonstrations, then they're a parrot. They're probably a poser. They're teaching what someone else told them years ago, and they can't shoot. Demonstrate as much as you can. And here's what I mean by that. If I'm teaching performance pistol, I demonstrate everything. The 15 years at the academy, I demonstrated everything I asked my people to do in that 83-hour program. Firearms for females, I demonstrate everything. If I'm teaching firearms instructor development, I don't necessarily demonstrate everything for two reasons. They've been through 83 hours with me already, they know my skills are on point, and it would take way too long with the amount of shooting and the amount of drills that I'm trying to relay to them. You shoot for your people, instructors, for two reasons. First of all, it builds confidence in you as an instructor. Lets them know you're a pro, you know what you're doing, and they should be listening to what you're saying. And the second thing is, it builds confidence in them. They may not say it, but even sometimes unconsciously, sometimes they will say, hey, if this person can do it, then I can do it. If you're taking a class from someone, if it's a shooting class and they're not shooting for you, more than likely they have no skill and they're just a parrot or a poser out there. Instructors, step your game up, shoot demonstrations for your people. That's where it's at, and that's what it's all about.